Look Outreach is underwritten by the generous support of Munter Enterprises. Family owned and operated since 1972, integrity is important, as our family name is on every project. Our word is our bond. Munter Enterprises. Just build it.
Welcome back, everyone. As Drew in the control room just said, how are you going to open this? You're going to wing it? And you'll find out why that's funny in a second. But I'm going to open with, there's a movie called Flight of the Phoenix. And there's a very interesting turn of events in that movie where they're stranded in the desert. They have to take apart the existing plane, build a plane, and fly out of the desert. And they find out that the engineer who's making all the recommendations on how this plane should be built has never been a pilot, that he was a model airplane builder. And it's a very telling scene, and I'm not going to tell you how the movie ends, but it ends well. But joining me today is Bob Lippman, who knows this movie and is also the president of the North Country Flying Tigers. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me.
Nice to have you here. You know this movie I'm talking about.
Oh, sure.
I know you do, right? It's got to be a Bible for your club, right?
Yeah.
The Flying Tigers is a model airplane club in our area. And, you know, that word model, when you stick it next to airplane club, to some people means, oh, it's not real.
Right.
Just the opposite is true. Ask Neil Armstrong.
Yes.
Guess, right?
Yeah.
So tell me about that.
Well, a lot of aviators and aeronautical engineers got their start in model aviation. Mm-hmm. And a model plane is really an airplane, just a lot smaller. It flies by all the same principles as a real airplane. It's built based on all the same principles as a real airplane, and it really can teach you a lot about flying. And when you're actually in the process of flying it, you feel like you're part of the experience, very much so.
Now, I have to ask a pretty civilian question here. Model airplanes have been around for decades.
Yeah.
Did they always have remote controls?
No. You know, model aviation goes back to the Wright brothers testing out their ideas by building models.
Right, right.
The Academy of Model Aeronautics goes back to 1936.
Wow.
So it's been around a long time, longer than the FAA.
Mm-hmm.
It's established a safety protocol and a culture of building and flying model airplanes that's really been an important part of the story of aviation in this country.
Oh, I bet it has. There's many famous stories during the 40s, World War II, when the military was testing a lot of their equipment by building models, correct?
Yeah,
and flying them.
Sure, yeah. And we have a lot of famous alumni from the Academy of Model Aeronautics. Neil Armstrong, probably a name people would recognize.
Sure, of course, yeah.
Paul McCready, Burt Rutan. I mean, all these guys got their start building model kits, flying model kits,
mm-hmm.
learning the principles of aviation, and just mm-hmm. falling in love with airplanes.
You know, you said something interesting right here. The principles of aviation, technology changes like crazy,
mm-hmm.
right?
Sure.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
But the principles don't change, do they?
You know, gravity is always there.
Yeah, right. You're telling me?
Yeah. But one thing that is changing is we have quadcopters now and mm-hmm. you know, what people refer to as drones.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a huge area of expansion now. It's getting a lot of people interested in the hobby. And our mission is to integrate that into the national airspace to do our part to make sure that people fly safely, know the rules, have a safe place to fly, and really become part of that culture and engage with the social aspect of it, which is really what keeps you coming back to it, too.
And it's a regulated field. This is serious fun, as we like to say.
Yes.
But the Academy of Model Aeronautics, right, AMA,
yeah. Yeah.
they're subject to working closely with the FAA, right?
Right.
And working with all of the clubs, setting standards.
Yeah. In fact, they were a principal reason why the Special Rule for Model Aviation was passed by Congress,
mm-hmm.
I think in 2009,
mm-hmm.
which codifies the relationship that model aviation has to full-scale aviation and exempts model aircraft from the normal rules that you would have for, let's say, general aviation or manned aircraft.
Right, and that can have to do with a number of criteria, including how high off the ground it can be, you know, weather conditions, all kinds of situations. Well, you're going to get a chance to see this firsthand because this Sunday coming up, the 9th,
that's right,
is the 9th annual Fun Fly Air Show. That's over in Fort Edward?
Yeah.
Okay, where is?
So the address is, I want to make sure I get it right, and it's 1933 County Route 43.
Yeah, great.
In Fort Edward.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually just a little bit south of what they call Adamsville Flats,
mm-hmm.
To the east of Hudson Falls.
Sure, Route 43 is actually very easy to find if you're over roaming around those roads over there. It's clearly marked. It's a beautiful airstrip out there that they've rented for years and years. And during the day, all kinds of demonstrations, right?
Yeah, we're going to have acrobatic flights. We're going to have first-person view, drone racing. We're going to have foam aircraft doing what we call 3D maneuvers, which are maneuvers that are so extreme that a human being couldn't withstand the G-forces of them, and planes can hover on their tails and do some really incredible stuff. Scale airplanes for people that are into history and into the history mm-hmm. of aviation or military history. There'll be a World War I and a World War II segment. And we'll have raffles. We got a silent auction going on. We're raising money for the Make-A-Wish Foundation of Northeast New York, so we're really excited about working with them this year.
Mm-hmm.
Every year the club has done a charity event for a local charity, and that's the charity we're working with this year. Really, really worthy cause.
Oh my God, yes, for sure. You know, and one thing that just strikes me about this, and you might recall the interview I did with Hank Ashen, part of the club for rebuilding and restoring Model A Fords, and Bob was saying about the relationship that he built with his son over working together on something like this, that, you know, to expose your kids to it, your grandchildren to it, is really building character. It teaches them how to negotiate. It teaches them a skill. It teaches them that combination of the cognitive skills and, you know, personal skills.
Yeah.
And that's what a club like this does. So if you've ever thought about this, or you think your child might be involved in it, you got to contact them. And
I'll tell you, one thing that it really teaches kids is perseverance. Because learning to fly a model airplane is not that easy, and you invariably are going to crash it a couple of times along the way, and you're mm-hmm. going to have to stop and rebuild it.
Mm-hmm.
Teaching a kid to take a step
understand
back,
that.
Take a deep
That's
breath,
right.
sit down, repair it, figure out what went wrong, and improve mm-hmm. on that performance, it's a key skill that kids really, really need.
And it stays with them for life.
Yeah, especially if you want them to excel in STEM. In science, technology, engineering, mathematics,
sure.
art, model aviation is a great stepping stone to all of those things.
It is. Now, it's Sunday. Head out to Fort Edward. It starts at 9:00 in the morning. It's going to go all day long. Money goes to Make-A-Wish Foundation. And you ready for this? Pack the car up, because it's $5 for a carload of people. That's right. Not $5 a head. $5 for a carload of people. Bring everybody you ever knew.
Yeah, we really want to share the fun, and it is a really good time.
Well, Bob, great. It's really nice that you took the time to come in and brought this with you and just talk about this. It's really exciting.
My pleasure.
Oh, you're quite welcome.
Thanks again.
To see this interview again, you can head to our website, looktvonline.com.